Okay, hello everyone. In today's video, I'm going to be showing you guys the things that I will personally be taking to the Speak Yourself concerts. Also things that you guys can take. For some reason, some people were under the impression that you absolutely must take a bag. If you don't need a bag, don't take a bag. For some reason, some people kept asking if taking things in their regular like jacket pockets is fine. And that totally is. If you don't need a bag, don't take a bag. My last video was for people that were already planning on taking a bag. It's a clear bag. It does not have to be like this one. For some reason, also people were getting under the impression that it must be this one with the open top. There are a bunch of different versions of clear bags. If you were to search on Amazon or any other type of store, it does not have to be fully clear like mine is. I know some of them are like a bit smaller and have the seams or whatever. They have like colors. They have like a colorful strap. Has zippers with the little flap, whatever. Those are okay. So these are some of the items that you can't take. If you're like a local or you didn't want to carry much, you wouldn't need a bag for these. Just take the things you would take if you were just leaving the house. Phone, keys, wallet, plus your ticket. Don't forget your ticket. Basically your essentials. You got that? You're good to go. Throw in an army bomb if you want, light stick. These can be purchased at the venue last tour for Los Angeles. They were selling them at the venue for $55, no tax. The places do take card or cash. If you don't feel comfortable carrying a bunch of cash, then I just suggest taking a card. Some extras you can also take, which I would highly suggest, is a portable charger. This one I got from Amazon. I've been using it for the past several years. It has two ports, and if you got some friends, you guys can share it. And then I have this one. Cable. It's like a bracelet, sort of. Smaller, more compact. I don't want to have a cable running out through my entire bag. Also, you're going to be taking your light stick. Don't forget your batteries. The light stick does take 3 AAA batteries. Don't forget those. But if you do forget them, or if you're just buying a light stick at the venue, they do sell batteries at the merch booth. So in case you forget them, or in case you buy your light stick there, you'll be fine. Also, I'm personally going to take some lip balm, just because my lips tend to get dry, and it's an open stadium, so the sun's going to be shining on you. Your lips are going to get dry. Actually, just taking some sunblock, since it will be an open stadium, and if you plan on getting there early, you'll be in the sun for a while. And also, I'm just planning on taking hairband and hairbrush. California weather in May is kind of unpredictable. It could either be super hot or super windy for some reason. So I'm just taking a hairband. Also, just in case you get sweaty after the show, hairbrush. I like one of these tiny ones. It's more smaller. It's got the brush right there. Also, personally don't like when I'm at a show and my hands feel sticky or something, especially when I'm using my phone to like record. I hate the feeling that my phone is dirty. So hand sanitizer or some wet wipes, that takes care of it. Makes you feel so much better. Also, if you're just like sweating at the show afterwards, just wipe yourself off, you know? Wipe your face. So these are some of the basics. The more essential ones are right here. These are the other, my personal basic essentials. Next up are the extras. Extras being things that you don't necessarily have to take, but if you want to, you can. Okay, so some of the extras you can take or you can buy at the stadium would be fan site slogans. I've used these the past tours, and the measurement of these smaller ones do comply with the banner measurements for the Rose Bowl. Like, there aren't on the stick or anything, so they're fine to take in. And usually fan sites will be selling these outside for like $10, $15. So if you want to buy one, you can, you know, just cheer for your faves. If you attend a lot of concerts, you understand the pain of being in the middle of recording something and having that dreaded no more space left, no more memory left on your phone message. Then you're frantically trying to delete all the apps and deleting photos of your family. Just to capture more pictures and videos of the band you're watching or whatever. I have an iPhone, so I decided to actually purchase the iCloud storage. Let me tell you, that thing is a lifesaver. I have so many videos on there, so many pictures. I don't have to worry about space running out on my phone. It's great. But before that, I had this thing, which is a little USB drive. You can connect it to your iPhone, plug it right in. This is a 32 megabytes. But you plug this in before the concert or whatever, offload all your family pictures, all your dog pictures from your phone, save it on here, clear up space on your phone, then you'll be able to go. Stop deleting pictures of your family, people. Stop deleting pictures of your family. Next up are cameras, and these have both been approved by the Rose Bowl. Your little Instax camera which a lot of people kept asking about in the last video, the comments, everybody kept asking about it. I already asked and that one's approved. Regular disposable camera is also approved. Other small personal cameras that don't have a detachable lens are also approved. The lens must be shorter than 3 inches when it's on full zoom. Next are things to decorate your bag with. These plushies that I showed in the last video are no longer allowed. At least in the Rose Bowl, they're no longer allowed. So, sorry Shiki, but you're not coming with me anymore. So, you can still use pins and keychains. So you like to decorate your bag with pins or keychains. Hard plastic keychains, no plushies. They're good. Also, since the stadium is outside and during May, it will be really hot, so people will be tempted to take a fan. And just know that these electronic motorized ones, like... these will not be allowed. If it has a motor, if it requires batteries, it's not allowed. So what you can take are fans like these little picket ones. These are fine. Some fan sites, actually, if you buy the Slogan, some of their cheering sets come with one of these. So you can find a fan site that sells both of them for one. That's a great deal. But if you don't feel like spending money on a little fan, you can just create one yourself. And here's my little DIY part of the video. So what you need is a sheet of paper. You could probably get a sheet of paper at the venue, like stuff fans pass out. You just want to grab a sheet of paper and just fold it a bunch of times. Just keep folding it till you reach the end. Fold one of these little side pieces and bring it out. Bam, get yourself a fan. There's your little fan. Also, because the Rose Bowl Stadium is an outdoor stadium in California, the sun doesn't tend to set a little later than 7 o'clock. So I'd suggest bringing some sunglasses if you are planning on hanging out there earlier. With that, bring a cloth to wipe your glasses, especially if you're like me and you require glasses all day, every day, because you can't see because you're blind. You were blinded by J-Hope. I'm sorry. That was really no jams of me. I'm so sorry.
Jessica.
Yeah.
You got no jams.
So for food and drinks, the Rose Bowl does not allow you any snacks whatsoever. No outside food. If you are planning on getting to the stadium early, if you do take food or anything, make sure to eat it before you try entering the venue. Security will make you toss it as you're going through the security check. But they will allow you in with 2 less than 17 ounce water bottles. They need to be factory sealed. You can't like chug half of it and try to go in with it. Please stay hydrated, guys, especially if you're planning on going to the stadium early. The show doesn't start till like 7:30. Please stay hydrated. Also, a lot of you guys in the last video, in the comment section, that seemed to be a big problem for people. Personally, for me, it hasn't, just because I don't really care anymore. I've been to a little too many concerts, okay, where this has happened. I personally do not care if anyone sees or anything, but some of you guys do, so. Feminine products. First of all, nothing to be ashamed of. It's a natural thing. There's not much you can do about it, you know? Just accept it, okay? Just accept it and your life will improve so much more. So, feminine products. If you don't feel comfortable having them shown in your bag, just put them in your pocket. Take a jacket or something, put it in your pocket. You won't have to take them out while you're doing your security check. Or, and this also goes for just overall security of your bag. If you don't feel comfortable showing anything in your bag, just take an extra flannel or jacket. Just throw it on top. See? People won't be able to see it. The only people that really need to see what's inside your bag and then you have to take this off is security. Whenever you're outside just hanging out in the stadium, you can just put your jacket over it. Okay, so let's pack up my bag, shall we? I took this set last year's tour. So I'm still debating about whether to take JK or Jin this year. Jin has grown on me so much in the past couple of years. But I think I'll take this one just because it's smaller than my other Jin ones. My Slogan. I definitely need my charger. I need my ticket, but I don't want everybody else seeing my ticket, so I'm gonna just place it in my little Slogan. Just for my own safety, my wallet, my wet wipes and sunblock. Am I trying to end up like Hawaii JK? So taking my hairbrush and my hair tie, just cause like halfway through the show, My hair starts to bug me. I can't stand having like hair sticking to my sweaty face. Then I'm gonna take my light stick and batteries. I'm gonna just put a small little hair tie around my batteries just to keep them together. Just because I know once that show starts trying to look for my batteries at the bottom of this bag, it's gonna bug me. There they are all together. I wouldn't suggest having your batteries in your light stick all day. That could actually damage the light stick. The light stick I'll be carrying. There's no need to put it in the bag. Phone. Obviously, you want to capture all those memories. I'm personally taking my disposable just because the Instax one, once it starts getting dark, it does not take really quality photo. Just a warning in case you're trying to take one of these to actually capture the performances. Once it starts getting dark, your pictures will come out kind of whack. So just like that's a warning, don't waste all your film. So taking this one, I'll take a picture of me and my friends before and whatnot. I'll be taking these sunglasses just because my eyes are very sensitive. I'm just wrap these in the lens cleaner. In the meanwhile, once I have to go through security, I'll just put them on. Can't forget about my lip balm. I love this stuff. I personally don't have a need for them, but I know some people like to take their earphones just in case they get there early and want to listen to music while they wait in line. So if you want to do that, go ahead. I personally don't have a need for these. I'm just gonna take this instead of the other fan just because if I do end up digging through my bag a lot, I wouldn't mind this getting bent. So just throw that in there and I am set to go. Got my bag with all my stuff that I plan on taking, my light stick